Well, details are still coming out surrounding the sudden death of rapper Juice WRLD. Drugs and guns were found on his private jet, leading to speculation that his lifestyle played a part in his death. And joining us this morning is DeAndre Hawthorne, also known as Black Ice. Thank you so much for coming on this morning.
Thank you for having me.
You are a poet. You are an expert in doing that, but you're also somebody who really cares about the community, and you are one that really works with a lot of youth that are interested in poetry and the hip-hop rap world.
Yes.
You know, we hear about somebody like this, so talented, and only 21. Mm-hmm. Was it the lifestyle he was living?
Well, again, 21 years old, coming from the community, the Chicagoland area, there's a lot of pull to get into the things of drugs and guns. And I don't think it was the fame more so than it was the choices that he made in his life.
Well, you're surrounded by that, though, and you're young and you've got money, or maybe you don't have money, but you're surrounded by this. It's very difficult to say no, isn't it? So what do we do about this?
Mm-hmm. Well, again, we have a lot of examples of greatness and positivity.
Absolutely.
In the community. So everyone is not making the choice to be involved in drugs or guns. And so we have to push the positivity that's in the community more so than talk about the negativity. It needs to be talked about, but we need more mentorship programs, and we need to be more hands-on with our youth.
But how do you, and I guess this is the challenge, if you're a rapper, you're somebody that wants to be a rapper, and then you end up, because, you know, there are people who want to be around you because you're famous, and then that's when the drugs come in, and that can happen in the rock world, not just
sure.
the rap world.
Absolutely. Yes.
But if you're a rapper and you're you want to write poetry to get you there, a lot of them feel like they have to glorify the drugs, the sex, the lean, all of that stuff.
And again, it's a part of the culture, but not just rap culture. It's a part of the culture in which we live in a society. The music is a reflection of society. So again, we have to do more of a job as mentors to reach the young people when they are having those ideas of aspiring to be that rap artist, that successful musical artist, and let them know that you can be like Chance the Rapper, you can be positive, and you can do positive things and still be successful at it.
Yeah, he's incredible what he's done. Every day he surprises us with all the philanthropy. But when you talk about mentorship, people at home are watching.
Yes.
Give us an idea of what we can do as a general population to help, because something needs to be done.
Well, I work with several organizations, the Legends of Chicago Hip Hop, in which I'm the founder of, and the poet organization. And all through the year, we go to schools and we mentor. We'll be going to the Juvenile Detention Center on the 21st of this month. And you can get involved by supporting organizations that are doing things. If you don't want to be involved yourself, support the organizations that are out here doing those positive things.
Any particular ones you would like to mention?
Yeah, absolutely. I just mentioned two, Legends of Chicago Hip Hop, the poet organization. You have MFMB Rappers, which are a young rap group that they just shot a video that I was in, talking about stopping the violence in Chicago, young aspiring rap artists. Impact Family Center is doing really good things also in the community.
All right, because you're a poet, and because you're so darn good at what you do, give us a poet, go give us a little, give us a quick poet about a young man, Juice WRLD.
Juice WRLD, Chicago. We brought people into the world like Juice WRLD. And all of a sudden his fame unfurled. And now we're hearing about the tragedy that had struck his life. But we can do more for this. It's time to entice the young people to get involved. And the mentors to solve the problems of our society. Or else we'll be hearing more about these type of tragedies.
All right, there you go, DeAndre Hawthorne, Black Eyes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for coming
on. You put me on the spot,
Anita. Yeah, but you did a good job. You could do it. Keep up the good work, too.
Thank you so much
for what you do to give back.
Thank
we
you so
appreciate
much.
It. Coming up, the Harlem Globetrotters are
coming. Look around. No, really. Look around. For real. There's this elevator, right? It's full of people. Some family, some friends, some strangers. But you're all in a basement. See, the basement represents that brand new idea that was blessed to be manifested in your mind. But by the time you share your idea with the 10 people standing in the elevator next to you, some of them get the hell off before the door even closes. Sort of like those so-called friends, the ones who you thought would be there through thick.